After a physical therapist used an over-the-counter infrared foot massager on a diabetic patient with decreased sensation, the patient developed blisters and wounds to his feet, resulting in a below-the-knee amputation of the leg, both legs. This is a real story, and there's more of these insurance claims that we'll get into. This is absolutely horrible, horrendous. This is another one that's actually happened. Following a hip replacement surgery, a 40-year-old man was doing a bench press on an exercise ball with 65-pound dumbbells in each hand. What? The exercise ball exploded and the patient hit the ground, fracturing his forearms. The PT testified during the deposition that he never inspected or rotated the balls prior to use, although he was aware that they were several years old. What on the earth? Why are we having people do bench press on a fair ball after a hip replacement or using aftermarket massage tools on diabetic feet? It seems really crazy, and I really do feel bad for these people, but these are actual stories from the 2016 claims report published by CNA and HPSO. And these types of equipment-related claims, like these ones that we just read here, they have an average paid indemnity cost or cost of $127,000 per incident. Those are some serious accidents and expensive, both for the patient and the clinic. I'll read more about these and talk about liability insurance in a second, but seriously, when was the last time your clinic changed their exercise balls out? So do me a favor this week and go to your clinic director and tell them the average cost of a claim for equipment malfunction is $127,000 and that you guys really do need new exercise balls if you haven't changed those out in the future. But please, please do not put someone on there with 120 pounds of weight after a hip replacement. That is just a bad idea. Here's the thing, when I read these stories and claims, it's really easy to look at it and say, you know, I would never do something like that. And yes, a lot of these types of claims in physical therapy are from negligence or equipment malfunction, and they all have one thing in common. No one expected something bad to happen. No one walked in that day and planned on seeing a college student walking in with a recent ACL repair and was instructed to walk backwards on a treadmill for 10 minutes when she fell and caused a lumbar injury requiring a lumbar fusion. Although the physical therapist and staff members were present, no one was close enough to the patient to support her when she fell. These things can happen to people of any age, any activity level, and it always happens when you least expect it. And that's why it's so important that we do everything we can to prevent these types of accidents from happening in the first place. And then we have to have a plan in place to protect the patient and our practice from malpractice suits that can happen without notice. Now, you've probably heard of malpractice insurance for doctors or dentists and how expensive they can be annually. You know, for example, an OBGYN can expect to pay more than $30,000 a year in malpractice or liability insurance. And I've even heard of figures much higher than that depending on the region or the practice. So when I started looking for PT liability insurance for myself, I was shocked to learn that as a physical therapist, I could be insured for just $150 per year. Now, there's a good chance that you're employed and you're probably wondering, well, should I personally buy liability insurance if I'm covered by my employer? And that's a really good question. And so I would challenge you with another question, which is this: do you fully understand your company's liability coverage? Are you still covered if they find you to be negligent in a situation, or could your license be in jeopardy in that case? So the question you need to ask yourself is this: is my physical therapy license, my livelihood, my ability to practice as a physical therapist, is that worth paying $150 for the entire year to be covered? I can't believe how many people wonder, well, is physical therapy liability insurance worth it? Is it worth $150? It blows my mind because other healthcare practitioners are paying thousands of dollars a year for coverage because they know how important the coverage is. Look, we're living in a day where legal battles are so common, and we're just one accident away from a lawsuit from a patient. So while the conversation may be a little bit different if liability premiums were thousands of dollars a year, there's not a question in my mind that $150 is absolutely worth it to stay covered from accidents you weren't planning to have in the clinic, but that's exactly why malpractice insurance exists in the first place. Look, when I was first doing research on malpractice insurance, I thought for sure owning a clinic or practicing outside a corporate setting would mean that I would end up paying thousands of dollars in liability insurance for my coverage. And while some insurance providers do charge more for self-employed liability coverage, I found top-rated coverage for just $300 a year through myptinsurance.com. Now, they didn't ask me to do this video. I personally used them and paid out of pocket for my own liability insurance, even though I do have coverage through the hospital where I practice. Now, you can obviously shop around, and I really do encourage people to find coverage that matches their needs, but you should check out the comparison chart here because it highlights some of the major factors that you really need to consider with a policy, and you can easily see which features are available among top providers for physical therapy liability insurance. And throughout my years of practice, I've held liability insurance with a couple of these providers, and right now I use my PT insurance because their coverage makes the most sense for me. So it's a nice chart and it's an easy way to compare features of different plans. If you're interested in liability insurance, I'd encourage you to check out my PT insurance. If you go through my affiliate link below, not only do you support my channel, but you also get the absolute best price on their PT liability plans, so check them out below. And if you're still on the fence about liability insurance, you can read my full article explaining the different coverages and what to look for in terms of physical therapy malpractice insurance and coverages among those different options that you'll see out there. You can see the link to both of those resources in the description below, but if you have any questions for me, throw them in the comments below and I'll do my best to answer them. As always, thanks for watching the video and I'll see you in the next one.